Penguin Random House Audio presents Abundance, the Inner Path to Wealth. This is the author, Deepak Chopra. This program includes a downloadable PDF that contains surveys and quizzes from the book. To all who envision infinite abundance. Introduction. Abundance and the Inner Path. There are many books on how to make money, but this one is unique, I believe, by unfolding an inner path to abundance. I want the listener to discover that abundance is a state of awareness. Consciousness is infinite, therefore, it has infinite gifts to offer. This is an ancient truth that lies at the heart of the yoga system in India. Far more than exercises taught in yoga class, they are not a part of this audiobook. The truths of yoga apply to every kind of fulfillment in life, including material fulfillment or wealth. Yoga is a magnificent word, and what lies behind its meaning is an even more significant vision. In Sanskrit, the word yoga means to join or unite. The English word yoke is derived from it. But where yoke brings to mind the image of a medieval cart drawn by a yoke of oxen, yoga illuminates an entirely new reality. In this reality, the things we normally think to keep separate are united. The two biggest things we keep separate are the two worlds each of us inhabits. One world is out there, the physical world of things and other people. The other world is in here, where the mind is constantly active, producing thoughts and sensations. The purpose of yoga is to bring these two worlds together. If you can do that, you will be happy and successful. Yoga emerged from the ancient Vedic culture that has guided Indian life for centuries. And money isn't excluded, certainly not on spiritual grounds. Artha is set out as the first attainment of life. And artha in Sanskrit means wealth. By following the principles of yoga, you will lead the life you were meant to live, one of sustainability, abundance, and joy. And along the way, the money to support this life will come to you. That gives you some idea why the vision of yoga is so magnificent. At a deeper level, yoga is about enlightenment. But for the purposes of this audiobook, achieving happiness and success is good enough, a worthy aim that yoga can achieve much more simply, quickly, and painlessly than you probably imagine. Given the hard realities, particularly in these troubled times, most people would be skeptical about the money will come part of this promise. Money is the chief worry that pollsters find in people's lives. Far from being supplied automatically, money implies hard work and struggle. To survive, you must have money. To thrive, you need even more. Yet even in the wealthiest Western economies, according to data gathered by the Gallup organization, only 1/3 of respondents say that they are thriving. The key to moving out of money worries isn't to work harder and gird yourself for the daily struggle until a future day when you can retire and relax with a sense of security. That day, once associated with age 65, has been pushed further and further off. Many people, even with very good financial prospects, foresee working until they are somewhere between 70 and 80. Nor is there any guarantee that retirement will bring a sense of security, much less well-being. Old age is a gamble on all fronts, but primarily health and money. If you have both, you have achieved something truly rare, a thriving tomorrow when most people are not thriving today. The money will come implies a very different approach to the whole subject of money. A shift in awareness is required, and no bigger shift can be imagined because the two worlds, in here and out there, come together. When this happens, life flows along a hidden path. You are not ruled by the outward path of work, finances, family, relationships, duties, and demands. On the other hand, you are not even ruled by inner beliefs, old conditioning, worry, whims, confusion, conflict, and the other discordant elements of the psyche. Each world is only half of reality. If you keep the two halves separate, you can't be whole. You will either be dominated by your external circumstances or your internal conflicts. The whole point of yoga, when it unites the two worlds of in here and out there, is to harmonize them. This can only happen in consciousness. You can only change what you're aware of. By becoming more aware, you can find the hidden path that brings together who you really are with the life you're meant to live. The money will come because being given what you truly need and desire is not left to divine providence, good money karma, the vagaries of life, or the whims of fortune. In short, a state of awareness brings happiness and success, with money as needed for both. Yoga is rarely attached to money, I know. In the West, only one branch of yoga is known to people, Hatha Yoga. This is the physical practice identified with yoga class, which is enjoying a wave of popularity unknown in the past. I have taken it up myself with unabashed enthusiasm. We won't be concerned with Hatha Yoga here, but if you practice it or have looked into it, you know that the positions taught in Hatha Yoga are about bringing together a centered state of mind and body. This fits the overall vision of yoga, bringing two things we normally keep separate into union. It is true, as the saying goes, that money can't buy you happiness, but poverty can buy you misery. Equating poverty with spirituality is a huge mistake, I think. There are virtues to living with simple needs, detaching yourself from worldly demands, and reserving most of your waking hours for spiritual pursuits. Not that many people, East or West, would actually choose such a life. But poverty doesn't make you rich in spirit, whether it is voluntary poverty, chosen out of purity, or forced poverty you can't escape. The real purpose of life is the same for everyone. It is this: connect with the generosity of spirit and let it provide everything you need. Is need the same as desire? Will yoga make all your wishes come true, showering you with wealth? Those are the wrong questions. Yoga brings inner joy, which is the only true measure of success. When we indulge in fantasies and wish fulfillment over money, we are compensating for a lack of joy. This audiobook is laid out so that part one addresses the issue of money and wealth. Part two covers all aspects of abundance. From yoga, we derive the things we most value: love, compassion, beauty, truth, creativity, and personal growth in consciousness. The more aware you are, the better able you will be to access those things in abundance. Part three reaches the deepest level of yoga, where bliss consciousness springs from the field of infinite possibilities. The focus of this part is the system of chakras, the seven levels where awareness can be fine-tuned and fully awakened. If yoga can bring joy here and now, what you need and what you desire will harmonize, because your whole existence will be harmonious. With such a complete vision in mind and everything to achieve, let's begin. Part 1. The Yoga of Money. Yoga provides us with the greatest way.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.